back to the papers. For today, I'll be teaching you actually a new tutorial, something I actually am gonna design as I go. We're actually gonna find it pretty cool. I already designed it, but I will teach you through it, and it will not be going as I go, but you get the point. So today I'll be teaching you origami fur, which it may seem impossible unless you're doing paper mache, but I'm actually working on a model with fur in it, and you'd be very surprised how pretty simple it is. So, I will recommend having some experience, though. So, let's get started. Start white side up. If you have double-sided paper, then use the color you don't, take the color you don't want and turn that side up. So now, fold in half. Unfold to the crease. Make sure to make strong creases, as always. Then, take this edge and fold it up to the where the two colors meet. Unfold, rotate 90 degrees, and repeat. And rotate another 90 degrees and repeat, except you don't have to fold it in half anymore. And repeat that when you rotate the last 90 degrees. Change the lighting a bit. Maybe this time. Perfect. It unfolds completely, and now what you're gonna do is you are going to fold this the corner to the second actually no you're gonna fold the corner to every intersection point along the diagonal. Let me change the view a bit. So one, you should count it, I believe, seven times. 1, 2, 3, I think it's 8 actually. 4, 5, yeah, it's 8. 6, 7, and 8. Another, you can pre-crease this however you want, but basically you're gonna make a few, if you know how to make a bird base, then make a bird base on each of these squares. Yeah, I know, it's gonna take some time. So now, rotate 180 degrees, this is my method, and repeat. So this time you're going, and when you get to this side, you're gonna go to every two intersections. That way you're not going to every intersection. Go to every intersection, because there's not really gonna be there's not gonna be any intersections, there's gonna be edges, but you get the point. This might be a bit longer tutorial, unfortunately. Not sure. I definitely won't be as long as my dragon scales, but feel free to. I think you're gonna like this. And if you're ever designing a model and you use this fur technique, make sure to use the hashtag the paper is fur. Thank you. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna fold the corner to the very first intersection, fold in half, and you're gonna go along every line that it intersects with vertically, and then you're gonna create a rabbit ear to this crease. Doesn't matter which side you're on, actually. Sorry for the background noise. And careful, you're greasing foil, because foil takes creases quite really well. Okay, now take the corner and fold off another square, and this time, since you're not going to use the middle, because the middle doesn't intersect with any squares, so instead we're going to use the two beside the middle. But You know, I'll be using a 6-inch square of gold foil that I got from Amazon.com, Toyo. Feel free to, if you want that paper, feel free to check it out. It's on Amazon.com. No, this is not, no, unfortunately, this is not, not because they paid me, or it's not, like, a, not like they sponsored me. Not like they sponsored this video, I'm just, like, giving Origami Paper companies what they deserve. And that is a lot, a decent amount of money for the people, for the paper. And love, because honestly, I don't think they get much. And the and there's a lot of origamists out there who don't know what's good, what paper is good, and what paper isn't. So I'm just trying to recommend it. Yeah, I'd recommend getting whatever color you want. But basically, it's easiest if you have like a color that's easy to see. For example, gold. And basically, you're going to keep doing that until you get to the very end, edge, and then repeat on in the other direction. Once you rotate 180 degrees. And go up another square, and so on and so forth. Of course, I'm not going to skip through this part. I like to make sure my tutorial is completely full and make sure you see every last bit. You know, it actually might be better if I zoom in one sec. That's better. There we go. Perfect. So let's see if you can see it a bit better up close. So I pulled this crease. Hopefully you're able to see that a bit better. So we have the rabbit ear. And unfold the rabbit ear by pushing it. And unfold this. But don't unfold this crease. This crease. And repeat in the other direction. And then we keep going until, like I said, until you get to the top. Like I said earlier, I do not cut out anything from my videos unless it's like if I like curse or something. I don't put that in my videos. I just completely just I would just simply just delete the video and redo it. I like to make sure I have quality content. Some of you may disagree about quality content, but I want to make sure people learn from all ages and all levels. And that's what matters to me. What I don't care about subscribers. I don't care about views. I care about making sure people have fun learning origami. And that's what matters to me. Hope you guys agree. Okay, so now we're gonna keep reheating. Good news, we're more than halfway there. At least this side. If this video gets 6 likes, or this is, you know what, I'm gonna make another challenge. Once, if this video gets 6 likes, or I get 30 subscribers by October 10th, then I will show you my secret project that I'm working on with the fur. And you'll see. I think you're gonna find it pretty cool. Okay, so now, keep going. But like I said, for example, if you wanted to do my dragon, like my fire breathing chaos dragon, you're always able to make a tutorial. I'm happy to let you do that. You can make as many tutorials on any of my models as you want. But remember, as long as you put my name, and if I see somehow that someone's plagiarized my content, I will not be very happy, and I'll try to call, maybe, I don't know, I won't, the point is I won't be very happy, and I'll try to do as much as I can to get the video deleted. So, plus, I always put copyright on my videos. At least I will. I don't know.
And keep going.
I will say this model is somewhat tricky. I mean, not in this model, this pattern slash tessellation. If you are attempting this model, make sure you have a decent amount of origami experience and experience with collapsing bird bases. If you're not sure you can do this, make sure you check out my Hercules video. It's gonna be exactly the same as that, but with a bigger scale, with a bunch more bird bases. But if you want to learn easier, with an easier example, and you don't think you're able to do this, immediately go to my Hercules Beetle tutorial. Immediately. You should not attempt this unless you know how to do the Hercules Beetle, in my opinion. Like I said, this might be a bit of a longer tutorial. But I'm not completely sure. I could be wrong. Okay, two to go on this side. I can tell you this crease pattern is going to look absolutely beautiful. I can tell you that. Yeah, I can't figure out what camera angle is the best. I'll try my best to show you. But if you have any ideas for what you design apps, I know YouTube doesn't really want me to turn on comments. I have no clue why, even though I try to. So, just feel free, if you want to ask me some questions, feel free to email me at theautisticwayaround@gmail.com. Hopefully you're enjoying this tutorial for you so far. If you are, make sure you like the video and subscribe. And make sure, if this video gets 6 likes or I get 30 subscribers and this is easier than you think, by October 10th, which is a special day for me, then, like I said, I will reveal and show you my secret model. That I've been working for, very hard on, that is, you know, hard to explain, it's hard to explain, but the point is, it's a one I'm working quite hard on, and it will be using the spur technique, but I haven't really been working on it much lately, so if you want me to complete it, make sure to give this video a like, and, if you're on iPad, make the thumbs up button turn gray, like I usually use to watch YouTube. Over halfway done, I can tell you that. Good job sticking. If you're still holding me, thank you for sticking with it. I can tell you, once you're done, this will be well worth it. Trust me. Just so you know, you can also make spikes with this technique. I prefer fur. I think it looks a bit more neat. in my opinion, but everyone's different, right? I don't know what that is. Okay, so you're half. A bit more than halfway done. So as you see, we have a bunch of bird bases. So we're gonna repeat that so that we do it on the other side too. But this time we don't have to make it completely folded in half, which is nice, right? Yeah, have a strong and thin paper because there's going to be a lot of layers, but you're going to have to do quite a bit of refolding and collapsing. Because refolding isn't a word, but it could be. Actually, I think it's a word, but the point is, you're going to need to have a strong paper that can withstand quite a few creases. But make sure it's a cheap paper, too, because you don't want to waste it on just this simple thing. Not simple, but... Not exactly simple, but just this thing that didn't really look that cool. It's more of like kind of like a trick or a tip than like an actual model, you know? The other side. Okay, two to go. And then we'll start the harder part, the collapsing. Ugh. Now, once you collapse it, I will show you how to shape it. There are many different things you can do with it, actually. You can turn it into scales, you can turn it into hearts, you can do many, many things with it. So, I'm telling you, please, please watch till the end. Or just fast forward, whatever you choose. Above the camera. I know, guys. I may seem really cool. You might be wondering who I am, but I cannot tell you any of that information, unfortunately. I mean, fortunately for me. You may be wondering what my name is, what my number is. Actually, I don't have a number, but what my face looks like. I cannot tell you. That is for later. But if I ever do. But the point is, if you ever want me to do it, stick with my channel, and I will, and I'll try to do. No, not tutu, but you know what I mean. Okay, we're almost there, really close. Oh, guys, I will tell you, once I hit 100 subscribers, I will do a huge, huge giveaway to celebrate. So make sure to subscribe if you want me to do that. Okay, so thank goodness, all the pre-creasing is done. Let me check my work. I'm gonna wait for something wrong. So now, let's collapse it. This time we're gonna be color side up, actually. And we're gonna start from the very corner, actually. So, zoom out a bit. And we are going to start collapsing. Like I said, you're gonna need a decent amount of origami experience with collapsing bird bases. And if you don't wanna try it yet, feel free to try out my Hercules Beetle, Origami Hercules Beetle, which has a similar technique with the machine here, collapse. Base almost collapsed. Oh, Come on. I got this. There we go. Okay, so now we're gonna collapse the one next to it. Now, actually, now that I think about it, you can do it in any order. So basically, I'll show you a few of them, and then you can stop. And no, never mind. I'm gonna show you the whole thing. Really. Actually, the best I can. I'm sorry if I go out of camera for a sec. Time. Okay, almost done with this ninja star. About the background noise again. Okay, so now we're going to tuck that in. And we're going to collapse the next one, the one on the other side of the original one. Maybe we can go around. Coming out one star at a time, in my opinion. So it works for me. But everyone does it differently, right? And tuck that one in. So our first one's collapsed. And we have our first, almost our first row collapse, I should say. Not all first row collapse. But we're gonna do this one now. So I'm gonna try to show it the best you can, but go basically go along the pre-creasing. That's the best I can show it or say it. Sorry. Mount hold along here and here. Okay, just do whatever you need to do. All I can say is try your best, right? That's all you can do. Nice thing about using foil for this is it just stays together quite well, actually. I like that. And basically you're gonna collapse it one ninja star, or whatever you want to call it, one bird base at a time. Just take your time. Unfortunately, there's no shortcut to this. I wish there was, honestly. But this might take a while. Okay, so now you're gonna keep collapsing, actually. Keep on going. Hey, I can tell you, this model takes a whole lot of patience. A real amount of patience. Decent amount. But it's gonna take quite a while, this tutorial, honestly. I'm not even sure I'll make it in time for dinner, but I'll try my best. Right. That's all one can do. Basically, you're gonna keep going. Oh dear. One sec. Move a few folders aside. Probably best if I don't narrate it. That way I don't, like, throw you off with my annoying words. And you're gonna just to stuff it in the best you can. And you might see one of these, the spikes that come up in the middle. Just tuck it in somewhere. Do the best you can, right? And you're gonna keep on going. One second, get a bit of a stretch. No clue what I meant by stretch, actually. Wasn't really a stretch, lol. best to use a smaller sheet of paper so it's easier to, like, keep track of. And when you're doing a decent amount more, you can always make a bigger and bigger grid. I can tell you, the one I'm making in, like, the smaller, the other one I'm making in, like, the other, like, my other one, is from a 256 by 256 grid, which is 32 of these, basically. So, it's going to take a whole while. Once, if my parents allow me, I'll try to collapse it live, actually. And keep on going. I'll try to show it the best I can, like I said. Okay. Okay, so now keep on going. Doing actually quite well, and I'm sure you're doing good too. I'm telling you, if you find this easy, stick with the model. Trust me, it'll get harder as you go. Can't believe we're about to hit the 40-minute mark. This is a lot longer than I expected, and I expected it to be quite long. Oh my. Doesn't really matter which way you collapse them. Some may be easier than others. Depends how you look at it. You got this. I believe in you. So, keep on going. Just
like this. And we're gonna keep going until we finish this. Like I said, I'm gonna show you the shaping afterwards. Don't worry. One second, Oh, look, we hit over 40 minutes. Wow, that's crazy. Okay, if you want to learn how to do that whistle, make sure to check on my new channel, Extra Hobbies. I will tell you, this channel isn't actually just me. I will have someone else actually posting it on videos on there too, so feel free to check that out when those videos go public. You know what I mean, right? Sorry about the noise. Try to show it the best I can, like usual, or sound the best I can, I should say. Right. That sounds good. Like I said, use a strong, thin paper, and it will really get you far. Also, paper that's easy to hold creases, but not too easy. I'm probably using paper that can hold creases a bit too well, just in case I make a mistake, you know? Probably not the best idea to use foil. I'm just using it to show you. It might be easiest to show you. But whatever you do, I would not recommend using foil. Trust me. It's not gonna go well. Man, my back hurts. Oy. Okay, we're gonna keep going. Like I said, this takes a whole lot of time. Just to save my grid, I can't imagine how long this is gonna take. Perhaps even part of that 256, the 256 grid. I'm 28 times more. Ugh. Okay, we're getting close. That's good. Indeed. Okay, as you see, we're getting really close, and soon we'll be done with the collapsing, at least I should say. We're not even close to done. We're kind of close to done with the whole tutorial. Okay, so now, keep going. Sorry for this taking forever. I'm trying. Not to take forever, I mean. Not trying to take forever. That'd be awful. Don't know why I'd ever do that. What the? Sorry, I didn't mean to do that. I said maybe not the best thing to do is use foil, but I tried my best, right? That's all I can do for you guys. Okay, so it's gonna look a lot like crumpled paper right now, but it will look more like a base soon. I can assure you that. Yay. We're on a bit more than halfway done. Yay. We got in there most of the hard stuff. Most of it. Now that we've gotten used to it, we can get a bit better at collapsing it. Am I gonna drop it in? Who knows? Hopefully not. Okay, as you see, we're almost there. Please, please, please. Can we get to one tutorial? One part. We're so close. Yay. Come on. Oh. Yay. So close. Like I said, stick with it till the end. You'll see what's pretty cool about this cool model. It's so cool about this model. And the finally the last few bird bases. And if you're getting frustrated, always stop the model and stop doing it. The only reason I'd ever keep going when I was frustrated is if I was doing a tutorial, and then I would probably make it to part two. Unless it was like going live. That's different, but I won't be going live for a while until my parents allow me. So close. Just gotta pinch it together. And we have our fur ball, which is not any fur ball, like my dog, but just a ball of fur, literally. Now, what we're gonna do. You're gonna pinch each part into a piece of fur. Like I said, quite a few times, because I actually mean it quite a bit. It'd be much easier without foil, but maybe I'll make a redo eventually. Who knows? This video gets popular and people don't like it. Okay, basically you're gonna pinch it, each one of them, each individual piece of fur, and just kind of push it down, you know? See the first starting the form here. So I've been doing the tutorial and we'll see you next time.